Ready to open the hood? Use tool for the tutorials.
And for car parts, the right idea is the Mr. Auto app. Easy, fast, and with better prices than on the website.
Turn your engine off and pull up the handbrake. To change the connecting rod bearings on your vehicle, we recommend watching our video, How to Remove and Change the Oil Pan on the 1.5 DCI. You can now access the crankshaft, which will enable you to change the connecting rod bearings. Since this engine has four cylinders, there are four connecting rod bearings to change. To access the rod bearings, you have to remove the rod caps. We recommend changing them one by one so that you don't mix them up. With a felt pen, mark the top of the bearing so that you can reassemble it the right way up. This is crucial, as you risk breaking the engine. The tops of the bearings have only one correct way to be assembled. Using a socket wrench, an extender and an 11mm socket, unscrew the two holding screws on the bearing top. Then remove it. You can now remove the lower connecting rod bearing. To remove the upper bearing, turn the crankshaft with a long nut on the damper pulley. Be careful, you always have to turn it in a clockwise direction. You can also push the bearing and bring the piston to the top to make it easier to access the upper connecting rod bearing. Using a flathead screwdriver covered with a piece of tissue to avoid scratching the frame, remove the upper connecting rod bearing.
Hello, if this video helps you, like and subscribe.
On this engine, the lower connecting rod bearing is not as wide as the upper one. Take the new set of connecting rod bearings, then start by oiling the top of the bearing. Do the same with the lower connecting rod bearing. Position it in the top of the bearing. Make sure that you center it completely and that it doesn't stick out of the top. Oil the upper connecting rod bearing. Before putting the different elements back in place, oil the part of the crankshaft where you're going to install the connecting rod bearings, then the lower part of the bearing. Put the upper connecting rod bearing in, ensuring it is properly centered. Put the lower part of the bearing back onto the crankshaft. Put the top of the bearing back in place, respecting the markings made with a felt-tip pen. We strongly recommend replacing the old screws with new ones. Screw the screws back in until they make contact with the top of the bearing and the bearing. At this point, take a torque wrench and set it to 20 Newton meter and tighten the two screws. Finalizing the screwing in process by adding a 45 degree turn. It is important to follow the instructions as these parts are subject to significant restrictions. You can now repeat the operation on the other bearings. To put the oil pan back in place, we recommend watching our video, How to Remove and Change the Oil Pan, on the 1.5 DCI.
Please support us. Subscribe and like the video, that will be really cool.